Hi everyone, I'm Cody, W3AMG with Bridgecom Systems, and today we are going to be showing you how to use the Bluetooth function on your Anytone radio, what it does, and what you can do with it. Awesome. So first, I have a couple Bluetooth devices here. I have the optional Anytone Q8 noise canceling Bluetooth earpiece. Then I also have the Bluetooth push to talk button, which is made to go on the steering wheel. So first, let's go ahead and pair our push to talk button. So it's very simple. We have our radio here. Just go ahead and click on the menu button. Then we're going to go down until we find Bluetooth. There you go. Select Bluetooth. And for the push to talk button, we do want to make sure it's turned on. So we're going to turn Bluetooth on. But the push to talk button is a little bit different than most. Instead of going into Bluetooth pairing, it actually pairs through a separate menu. So you're going to go just click the up button, go back around to the last menu, and BT PTT pair. So that is the one you're looking for that button. So go ahead and select it and just click pair and then connect. And then just after you do that, hit the button on your push to talk button and it's going to start flashing and they will start looking for each other. We'll give it a second here. There we go. Bluetooth PTT connected. It's telling us that the Bluetooth PTT actually has a low battery, which makes sense because I don't think it's been charged in about a year. So we're doing good there on the battery life, but we are now connected. So if we were to back out here and if I was to press this button, that keys up the radio. So it's totally hands-free. It's awesome on the road because you can just hit the Bluetooth button. The next part of this that we will show you makes this even more awesome. Not only do you have hands-free operation, but you can actually connect this up to other Bluetooth devices. If you have a Bluetooth car, so if your car has a Bluetooth stereo in it, and that allows you to connect to cell phones, if you can connect your cell phone up to your car, most modern cars, even for the last 10, 15 years, have had this technology. You can actually pair your radio up to your car as well. Use that Bluetooth push to talk button and you'll be totally hands-free in your car. Now, if you don't use your radio in your car and you want to use it on the go, they make this Bluetooth earpiece. We sell these, you can get them. They're actually a really good deal for a Bluetooth earpiece. So we'll open this up here, show you how to use it. So we've got our earpiece, pretty simple. We'll go ahead and find the power button. So here we go, it's actually on the side of it right there. So there's a light on the back. So we're gonna hold that power button down, turn it on, wait till we see that light. See if I can, oh, the light's on this side. There you go, so that's the light. We've turned it on. You can see the flashing red and blue light. That means it's looking to pair. So we're going to go into our menu here. We'll go back to the Bluetooth menu. And this time we're gonna go to Bluetooth pairing. Seek Bluetooth. And at this point, it's going to be looking for our earpiece. And there we go, Q8 earpiece. So select that. Now it is convenient. The radio will let you know if you've got low power on your push to talk button, for example. So it is it's an awesome little feature there. Awesome, so we have that connected up. Now we are good to go. So now at this point, the radio is going to use this device as our earpiece or our speaker and microphone. So you got your microphone and your earpiece. This will actually work with just about any other Bluetooth device. If it has a microphone and a speaker in it, it's gonna work with it for the most part. We've had folks use them with hearing aids, with Stena headsets for their motorcycle. They work great for that. And just about everything in between, generally it will work with it. So if you need to enter a PIN code, some vehicles actually require a PIN code for the Bluetooth to work, what you'll do is go back down to the Bluetooth menu and there's an option here. There's some different options here for gain. You may want to turn your gain up and down just depending on how it sounds. Have some people help you with that. If they're saying you're too quiet or too loud, play around with your gain. Same goes for them. If they're too quiet or too loud, you can play around with your speaker gain. So, but this is what you're looking for if you need a PIN code. So Bluetooth PIN code, if your car has like a PIN, a number, you'll want to actually put this in your radio here. And at that point, it will allow you to use it with your vehicle.